So hi and welcome back to the show. My name is Gavin McRae, and I'm from GJ McRae Foundation Repair, and this is our new video series where we tackle all things basement waterproofing and foundation repair related here in the Greater Toronto Area. We call this series In the Field, where we not only break down the premise of foundation repair, but also show you a complete time-lapse production of a full repair process after this top-down video is complete. So let's get right into it. So this project was a unique one. A client reached out to us and wanted to replace some existing sonotubes that were essentially holding up a one-story structure. And the city basically required that these sonotubes be removed because they were undersized, and basically wanted them replaced with larger diameter sonotubes with new joist reinforcements as well. So this project was a tricky one because shoring and securing the structure so that its main concrete supports could be removed was quite a tight access operation overall. So we basically started with some custom lengths of telescopic jacks that could be tightened beneath the structure. The access here was only approximately 24 inches in height. So crawling under this structure and shoring it up in a safe way wasn't the most straightforward exercise. But once we had the structure shored up properly, we began excavations in the area of the existing sonotubes by hand. So after exposing these undersized existing sonotubes, we checked our shoring to be safe one by one there. So once the existing sonotubes were removed, the structure was essentially floating at this point. And this is when we dug and formed up three new concrete footings. Now, once these footings were cured, we installed three new 20-inch diameter sonotubes and replaced the complete joist support with fresh timber. Then we installed galvanized saddles and connected them directly to the timber joist supports, then to the sonotubes, and we fastened those to the underside of the new timber supports. So once everything was leveled and fastened and all the proper hardware and the three new 20 sonotubes were backfilled, we then filled the sonotubes with concrete. So the sonotube connection directly from the base of the footing to the underside of the new timber supports were poured essentially all in one shot. So the sonotubes were completely filled full of concrete. We cleaned the tops and floated things level and basically let these 20-inch sonotubes cure. Then the next day, we essentially removed the shoring and dropped the structure back onto our new 20-inch concrete sonotube supports. Then the last phase was installing proper hardware anchors through the galvanized saddles into the new timber supports. Then once that was done, things were essentially complete, and three new 20-inch sonotube supports with footings were now directly connected to the underside of the structure while the structure was hanging, essentially. Then, of course, we did sort of a nice final cleanup. So, that's the general breakdown of where, why, and how a project like this comes to pass. So enjoy the full time-lapse video of this project coming up next. And thank you for tuning in. And if you have any questions related to basement waterproofing, foundation repair, or underpinning, give us a shout at any time. We can be reached on the web at wetbasements.com. Thanks again, and we'll see you on the next project.